laps to go. Kunze now leading and a reluctant leader, obviously. Lopez in second place. De Bela, Cova, and there goes Kadir. And it's the old African game of fast, slow, fast, slow. It's quite obvious now how they're working it out. David Moorcroft, over the years you've seen these boys in action, and it seems a familiar pattern, doesn't it?
It does, and it certainly is difficult to contend with when you're running. It ruins your rhythm and puts you in a sort of difficult position. I'm sure Brendan would agree. Really, all the athletes want is a good, fast, even pace. In many ways, when it slows down, everybody boxes and gets together. It creates far more difficulties than actually a fast, smooth pace.
Well, I agree with that, Dave. I mean, I always prefer an even pace. And when you're running too slow, you still get nervous, and that's what I used to find. I don't know whether you agree with that.
Yeah, I mean, if the pace is fast, you haven't got time to think. But if it's slow, all you can think about are the problems that are being created. And often, the mind's your worst problem anyway.
And going fast and slow has been used to absolutely no effect here, because they're no better off than they were if they'd just gone slowly.
And the intelligent ones are the ones who are sitting back and letting them get on with the nonsense and just moving through. And I keep coming back to Cova, the fact that he's kept his head, like you said at the beginning, that he would do, and he's looking good at the moment. In fact, it's very reminiscent of the final in Athens, isn't it, really?
It's very, very similar to that race in Athens. And if you remember, in Athens, there was Vigneault showed on the last lap, as did Lopez, as did Schildauer, and as did Vigneault. But in fact, they're all there, the whole field's there. Nick Rose is there. Nick's run well, he's done nothing wrong so far, and just tracking Vainio, and right behind him is Alberto Salazar, who seems to be struggling every time they move.
The clock shows the rapid changes in pace. The last four laps went 66-67, and then suddenly back to 71-71. Steve Jones now right up with the leaders. Nick Rose with Vainio about four or five from back. Kadir leading, Lopez second, Abela third, Nenau of America four, Kunze five, Steve Jones in sixth place, Cova is seventh, Schildauer eight, Perla nine, Prieto ten, Levnis Shahanga, who's going back a bit, Gomez is 12, Jorgensen is 13, Vainio 14, Nick Rose 15, and Salazar 16. Well, Shahanga's in no position to do very much from there. The man with the yellow shorts, who's been the one who really has put the screw down.
And Steve Jones moves up on the outside there. And I bet he's thinking, well, I might as well run at the front and push them along a bit rather than get them in the midst of all this. And he's in about fifth place there, right on the outside. And he is the hard man of the track. He's run a tough semi-final the other day, 27:45, and that was the second fastest he'd ever run. And he's quite happy to go. If he's going to lose, you might as well lose by trying to run fast and running hard.
Nanao's been with the leaders quite a long time too. He was third in the American Championships. Kadir now on the curb. Lopez between the two Ethiopians, the other one's De Bela, and Nenau in the centre of the next group, with Kunze on the curb and Steve Jones on the outside. Then comes Cova, Schildauer, Herla, Gomez, Prieto, Shahanga. And Mamedes just can't get back in this race at all. Seems to have lost Salazar. I don't know whether he's gone back in the pack. Salazar just tucked in the back of the leading group. But Mamedi just can't get with them at all. Meanwhile, Lopez has rarely been out of the picture, his Portuguese teammate.
Salazar, in fact, was 50 yards off the pace at one stage. They've slowed down and come back to him, and he's now at the back of the pack. Nobody really wanting to take it on. Everybody looking across to see who's going to cut away soon. And it's going to really hand it over to the tail-end sprinters, because they're coming up now with six laps to go.
Well, someone really has got to do a Brendan Foster and put in three really fast laps to kill the sprinters. They're coming round with six laps to go, and Vainio being roared on as he comes through to take the lead. Now, is this the break we're waiting for? He won it, the European Championship, from the back in Prague, but now he takes them on from the front. Listen to this crowd. Bionu out in front. Padilla in second place. Lopez third. Twins are four. Five is Neno. Six is De Bela. Seven is Steve Jones. Eight is Schildau. Ninth is Cova. Nick Rose just on the back of the leading group. But that's really sorted them out. Gomez has dropped off the pace entirely. So too has Salazar's dropped again. And the lead is by Salazar.
Well, that was the first really positive move we've seen in this race. But it certainly wasn't the last, because he's done nothing to get rid of the field. It was an injection of pace rather than trying to make a run for home. And I think all he's going to do now is he's going to wind them up towards the finish. And still the group is haunting him. Still the group is on his shoulder. He's making a little move again. He's making another move, but he hasn't done anything significant enough to win the race yet.
Well, the pace changed entirely then with a 63-second lap. We don't really expect to see Bionu there, and he looks to me now as if he's saying, OK, I've done my bit, you come and help. He's looking back at the Ethiopians, but they're not making any sort of move. 4.5 laps to go, the Finn leads. The tiny Ethiopian, Kadir in second place. Lopez is third, Kunzer is four, Shahanga is five. Cova in sixth place, Schildar seven, Tabela eight. And Nick Rose moving through into ninth place. Be interested to see what sort of pace Bionu has maintained on this lap. That 63 seconds has made a very big difference indeed, but now he's slowed it down again. He's looking for help, and no one will go. A 66 second lap, most of the speed work in that being done in the first 300 metres of that lap.
And he just glanced over his shoulder to Lopez and said, come on, you take over. And I think Lopez has decided, I'll take over, but I'll take over when I want to take over, not when you want me to take over. And that's part of the game of this thing. They're doing what they want to do, not what the field tries to dictate to them. And it's gathered again. Nick Rose is still in amongst that group, as is Steve Jones. And they've both run very, very well to be with this class field at this point in the race. And Nick's got every chance. Nick's in there. He's running comfortably. He's got a fastest finish as many of these people. He just punched the Kadir. He actually punched him across the shoulder there. And it was a response from the fact that Kadir pushed him. So Kadir's gone round the outside and he's gone. And he was sent on his way by a punch from Nick Rose.
So three laps left now. And there are 13 men covered by about 7 to 8 meters, all in with a chance of the world title. That lap very slow, 71. Kadir now leads. Lopez in second place, Kunzer is third, Bainio four, and that's Salazar, the world's fastest marathon runner, who's now some 110 meters behind him. Kadir and Lopez locked together. Kunzer, that very fast finisher, in third place. De Bela is fourth, Bainio five. And they're absolutely bunched. In the pack there, Steve Jones for Great Britain and Nick Rose. There's Big Schildau, the West German, so powerful. The West German champion. Won the silver medal in the Athens 5 and 10,000 metres in the European Championship. Schildau wearing 377. So the East Germans with a very powerful hand here. So too the Ethiopians. And now it's Christoph Herlo, fellow of the first bend, very much back in the race alongside Lopez and Kadir. Chahanga's out of trouble and now. Some pushing going on. Bainio easing Kunzer out of the way, trying to get through on the inside. And Kadir puts his hand up for some reason, almost to say, you're not coming through here. Lopez in second place, Kunzer third. Chahanga goes third now. Schildau moving up on the outside for East Germany, outside his teammate Kunzer. They've got a lap and a half left. It's really on now. Just under 600 metres. Lopez has been with the leaders all the time. He's in second place. Kunzer's been there as well. But the new figure right there is Schildau wearing 377. Nick Rose and Steve Jones both chasing hard, but Steve Jones losing out slightly for pace. Schildau now makes the strike for home. 440 metres from home. Kunze goes through. Vaino elbows his way through into third place. Johanga is four. Cova is five. Kadir is six. And Lopez seven. Well, that's the break. Schildau now has played his cards and gone for home from 440 metres. In second place is Kunze. Third is Vaino. Four is Johanga. Five is the European champion Cova. But it's still Schildau. Massive East German beginning to tire. Kunze closing, the former European 5,000 metre record holder. What's Vaino got left? Cova doesn't seem to be able to get there. Schildau looking desperate. He's kicked again. Kunze is East German teammate coming on the near side. And Vaino trying, but it's Schildau with all that power holding the curve. And Cova! Cova of Italy on the near side. And Cova comes through to win. Schildau second. Third is Kunze. Four is Vaino. Five is Schahenker. Six is Lopez. Seven is Nick Rose. Eight is Erler. Nine is Kadir. Ten, De Bela. 11, Prieto. And 12, Steve Jones. And you will rarely ever see a better finish to a distance race than that. 200 metres, you could say that the Italian European champion Cova had no chance. He must have run a stupendous last lap. He came from so far back. Nick Rose and Steve Jones, both very much in the race all the way. But what a finishing spurt by this man.
Well, Cova was the one I picked out before the race, but that was mainly because he told me about his training session that he'd done, which said he could run under 27 minutes, and I think I believed that. But that was a fantastic race. A few of the boys gave it away, and there they come round the bend. He's got absolutely no chance. He's moving up onto the outside. Vaino looks as though he's got a chance, and the two East Germans look as though it could have been 1-2, and he doesn't give up. He's 50 yards from the line, and he goes into another gear. I've never seen a finisher like that in the 10,000 metres, David.
Brilliant sprint finish, and I think Schildau never saw him and thought he'd won the race. What's Schildau's reaction? Cova wins it, and Schildau, in a moment, raises his hand to the crowd as if he's won. So, Cova, the European champion, becomes the champion of the world.